Some time ago, there was a reception party on the top floor of Hyatt Regency Hotel in Tokyo. Speakers scheduled for the international symposium to be held the next day were enjoying a conversation. Looking outside the window, the sun was about to set, with lights in the building's windows taking over the orange sky. Arriving late for the party, I saw a couple enjoying conversation in English while drinking Chardonnay. The lady was one of my friends, but I didn't know the foreign gentleman. I joined their conversation, and after 5 minutes, I asked them, "By the way, how did you know each other?" They replied, "We just met here 10 minutes ago." I thought they were old friends, and they looked so comfortable with each other. I took particular note of the way the gentleman spoke. Relaxed and calm, yet charming and warm. The next day, all of us gave lectures, and I realized who he was. His name is Professor Mark von Idstein. He is a discoverer of Rilenza, the first drug developed to target and treat influenza virus infection. Rilenza has been available since 1990 and the more familiar Tamiflu since 1996. What led to the development of these two successful antiviral drugs? To answer this question, we need to understand the mechanisms involved in influenza virus infection. Virus cannot infect a cell unless it binds itself to the surface of the cell. To recognize the proper host cell, all viruses have proteins sticking out from the surface. So these proteins recognize particular molecules on the surface of the host cell to initiate infection. Influenza viruses bind to sialic acid on the surface of host cells. The many of the sialic acid containing cells are found in the airway, a protein on the surface of the influenza virus called hemagglutinin, binds itself to the sialic acids and permits the entry of the virus into the host cell. The viral particles inside the cell are then disassembled to release viral nucleic acid, which are integrated into the host cell DNA and hijack host enzymes for replication. Inside the hijacked host cells, the many viral proteins encoded by the viral gene are synthesized. Then, mass-produced viral genes and viral proteins are assembled and released from the host cell to infect other cells. The hemagglutinin initiate this initial binding to the sialic acid. So now that you know the mechanism of viral infection, how would you prevent this process? Consider the mechanism again. Viral infection and replication utilize the cells of host organisms. Drugs that inhibit these cellular processes may affect uninfected cells. The drugs need to work only on viruses. Influenza virus infections could be prevented with drugs that inhibit viral hemagglutinin from binding to the sialic acid on the host cell. This process. Many scientists have considered this approach. However, Lidenza and Tamiflu were developed with a completely different approach. To understand how Lidenza and Tamiflu work, we need to know a second viral surface protein called neuraminidase. In the next video clip, I will tell you about this interesting enzyme.